DAX measures are amazing, but have you tried visual calculations? They let you do things like percent of total or percent of parent directly in the visual with just a few clicks. No extra measures, no complex DAX. It's like magic. If you've ever struggled with writing or managing tons of measures just to get simple insights, visual calculations can be a game changer. And once you see them in action, you'll wonder why you didn't use them sooner. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online programs on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. All right, so let's get started with our visual calculation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one visual from here, and we'll put it on this page and turn it into a table. By the way, a tip from me that tables are a great place to be writing or debugging your DAX measures. All right, let's clean up a few things. So I increase the font size and I'm gonna turn off the title. We don't need that. All right, so you can say, and we gotta take off sales prior year. And first we'll start with percentage of total. And then we'll show you the visual calculation for percentage of parent. So you're gonna click on the three dots on this visual. And you're going to click that and you will select new visual calculation. You have a lot of options here. And the one to select is percentage of grand total, percent of grand total. So click that and it makes this visual go to this focus mode and shows you a panel at the bottom, which is the editing panel for this. And now Microsoft is constantly updating this. So this might look slightly different. They're adding capabilities. So visual calculations is certainly the place to look at. And you're gonna love it. So percentage of grand total, and it has the function filled in and you just have to select the values here. So first one, you can click on field and you can notice we only have one kind of numeric measure in here. So that's the only one that's showing up. If you did have multiple measures, you can select from that. So calculate sales, that's the first one done. And you notice that it highlights it in color. Kind of like Excel, you know, you write a formula, C1 is A1 plus B1, and you click on that cell and you can see it highlighted. That's kind of what's going on here, which I think is really nice. And then it says collapse all, and the field is like the calculation. So I think of it kind of like calculate. I'm not sure if that's the right way to think about it, but you know how you say calculate sales and you change the filter context. And in this one, you say calculate this field and you don't change the filter context, you change kind of the visual context, right? So you're operating on the visual shape, and that's what you need to remember when thinking about visual calculations. So it's a little bit different than your traditional DAX measures. So here, and I want it across rows, so I'm gonna select that option. Depending on your scenario, you might select different things as well. And that's it. I'm going to click the green arrow to commit. And there we go. We have the percentage. Now, of course, the first time I did it, oh, by the way, to get out of this mode, you can just click on back to report and you're back here, right? And of course, if you want to go again in the edit mode, you can click on the pencil next to the edit visual calculation. And it's going to take you back to that if you need to make a change. Now, the first time I did it, I kept looking here to be able to format it as a percentage. And you know how in DAX measures, you can select it and you see the measure tools. Well, the only place I've found right now is if you select the visual, go to its format properties and click on the data format. All right, so you got to remember that. And once you do it, you're like, okay, I know where it is, right? So percent of grand total, and now it is a decimal number, so you're going to leave the data type as decimal number, but change the format to percentage, and here I'm just going to do one decimal place. And just for fun, I'm going to add some color to it, so conditional bars, data bars, and let's give it some nice Power BI-ish tones. All right, so now we can see that, right? All right, so this is all pretty cool, but let me show you the best part of visual calculations. The best part is that, again, it's tied to the visual. So it kind of always works. So I'm gonna copy paste this one. And instead of month, I'm gonna change it to maybe the territory's country. And it still works. And of course you could change it to something else. Let's try product color. And you can see it kind of works for that one as well. I'm trying to make them all fit. And if you had slicers on this page, let's bring in maybe product category, set that as a slicer, maybe something from the customer table. We're gonna say total children, how about that? All right, and yeah, it is responsive, and in a way, it's simpler than DAX measures. Like, you don't have to think about it once you define it, but here you can see that if I select just bikes, everything kind of filters down, percentage grand total, just calculates for the grand total. You can say total children is 2. It filters down further, but the visual calculations are working. Now let's take a look at percent of parent. So let's look at percent of parent. Oh, by the way, you can grab this file if you want to examine it and follow along at learnpowerbi.com/download, along with a lot of our other best free resources. So go to that URL, get all my best resources and download files to get started with Power BI. Okay, so for this one, we're gonna turn it into a matrix, and I'm gonna remove the percent of total that we have, or you know what, should we leave it there? Yeah, we'll leave it there so we can contrast it. And now I'm gonna make it hierarchical. So I'm gonna add, let's add product country. So I'm going to put not product country, territories country, and I'm going to give it the plus minus icon. So I'm going to go to the properties, turn those icons on. So now you can see, and you can see how this is working, right? So as soon as I go into January, Australia, this one is indeed giving me the percentage of grand total. So it's saying this value is what percentage of that. And that is accurate. That's fine, 4% of grand total. But what if I wanted to do percentage of parent, right? So for that, we're gonna go back into visual calculation. I'll say new visual calculation, and I'll choose percent of parent. Now notice this formula is pretty similar, but instead of collapse all, we have collapse. It's pretty similar, so divide, we select the field. Now you see we have two fields in the visual pane. So we're going to select sales, and then collapse again works similar manner. So we're going to say collapse sales. Think of it like calculate sales, but the second part changes the visual context. So yep. So collapse rows, and I'm going to hit commit, and we can see the results here, but we're going to go in here and we're going to format it again. So we're going to go to properties, data format, percent of parent, format it as percentage, maybe one decimal place. I would like to see some colors, so I'm going to right click on it, conditional formatting, data bars, and let's make it kind of a light purple maybe. And this time I'm just gonna, maybe I should have done it for the other one. So since this is percentage, let's see if we can just make it 0 to 1. I'm not sure if that's a good idea or not. Let's try it. Ah, shoot, that wasn't a good idea. Let's try. So January, if we go in here, maybe that was fair. So we can see the percentage of total is doing its thing, but this one, and again, you can do the math if you like, 595 divided by 1860. I mean, roughly in my head, I'm like, yeah, that's about 1/3. And you can see that's 30%, right? Now, this is what I absolutely love, love, love about visual calculations, that they're not tied in to your values here, like month and country and so forth. Generally, when I'm writing DAX measures to do something like this, it's kind of hard-coded. I would have a reference to calendar month in there or territories country in there, but visual calculations doesn't care about any of that. It's just going on the shape. What that means is you can do this. So watch this, I'm gonna swap this order and you don't have to do anything for the visual calculation. It's still gonna work, right? So I'm gonna swap country over there and boom, it just works. So now you can go to Australia and understand that, hey, what percentage is January off the total? And you can see that, yep, you know, so basically this one And you know what? Let me change the conditional formatting. That idea didn't work out. Data bars. And I'll just say low to high. Okay, that's much better. So now we can see that the visual calculation that you have the high months where this one and this one. Hey, so I will admit I was initially very resistant to visual calculations just because I've been using DAX measures for years. And it felt like, oh, just when I had figured out kind of how to write DAX measures, then along came along this new thing. And I'm like, no, I don't want it. But it is a very useful feature and I'm looking to explore it more. And I'll keep sharing with you as I learn. Now, of course, if you want to learn all about DAX, all about data modeling, and Power BI in a structured program where you have live Q&A calls to help you over roadblocks when you get stuck, then visit learnpowerbi.com and check out our training programs. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.